I like it when the websites add new tools for our genetic research, and MyHeritage has added one that could help you. Today, we're going to talk about filtering DNA matches by genetic groups on MyHeritage. Now, in a previous video, I showed you about the genetic groups and how that can help in some ways with your genealogy research. In particular, it's very useful for people who don't know who their parents are to give them an idea of where their ancestors came from. But what we really need is to be able to identify the matches that might be in those genetic groups, and MyHeritage has added that tool now to their program. Let's go over to MyHeritage and see how we can do this. Now, first off, I'm going to go over to the ethnicity estimate and look at genetic groups again really quickly. Here we can see that I have genetic groups at the mid-range. There's six of them. If I take that back to the high range, I just have two of them. As I scroll down here, I can see that England number 13 over in England and Mormons in Utah and Idaho are the two genetic groups that I have a high confidence in. As I add into the moderate, it's got a few more groups, both in England and the United States. And even the low, it's got several other groups as well. Again, concentrated in those two areas. In this case, let me just focus on these two, the England number 13 and the Mormons in Utah and Idaho. Those are the genetic groups that I want. Now, this list doesn't show me the matches from that group. If I click on that group, it tells me that, hey, for England, there are 28,000 people in that group, DNA kits in that group. And there's 12,000 kits linked to trees in that group. So that's a lot of good information. If I look at the Mormons in Utah and Idaho, it's a much smaller group. There's only 838 people in that group and 419 trees in that group. Now, how can I find which of those 838 people or how many of them I am related to or I have a DNA match to? Well, over on my DNA matches list, if I go to filters, I did a video on this before and you saw some of the ways you could filter. They've added all genetic groups now to that. It's the one right at the end. If I click on the drop down, I can choose a specific genetic group. So remember, with England, there was 28,000. I look at that. I have 3,796 of my DNA matches with that group. So about 1 in 7 of all of the people in that group, I have a DNA match with. That's pretty neat. I could go down and scroll through and see which of those closest matches are mine as well, and see which ones might have the trees, which ones we might have a theory of family relativity, or any of the other tools. So it's a way to narrow down this list. Now let's go and take a look at that other group, the Mormons in Utah and Idaho. Now this only had 800 people about in the group, and I can see here that I'm related to 208 of them. So a quarter of all the people in this group, I have a DNA match to. With the other details here, we can see how closely related we might be. I can use these other filters also to narrow this down even more. For instance, let's say I want to just look at close family, which is going to be, you know, me and my relatives that I know. Well, it has both of these filters and now I'm down to just 12 matches. So when you're looking at this data, you can see that you have thousands of matches, tens of thousands of matches in some case, on MyHeritage. But by using the filters, what we can do is we can narrow that down. So for instance, I have 12,000 matches on MyHeritage. By just filtering it down to the ones that are part of that England number 13 group, it narrows it down to just under 4,000 matches. And if I wanted to look even further, maybe by a location or a place, I could narrow that down to maybe a couple hundred or maybe just a couple of dozen. That's a lot easier to go and look through than 10,000 matches. So use those filtering tools on MyHeritage to help narrow down where you're going to focus your research. And now that they have the genetic groups to be able to filter by, you can see matches that are specific to any of the genetic groups that you are a part of. Now, if you'd like to learn more about the genetic groups, then watch this video up here. But if you want to learn something else about DNA, then watch this video down below.